Hello, my name is Jeroen van der Waal, professor of sociology and coordinator of the Master Program Politics and Society. I will now present this program to you. It has a unique focus on the link between politics and society. Why? There are heated societal debates and public concern about the increased gap between politics and society. But of course, politics does not exist in an isolated field. It can only be understood in wider social context. In this master program, we therefore do not focus on either politics or society. Instead, we study both simultaneously. This is reflected in our staff, which includes scholars from sociology and from political science. What do we study? In general, we include in our analysis differences in attitudes, cleavages, polarization among the public, and analyze how this is related to the political domain. How is it related to both formal political participation, such as voting behavior, and informal participation, such as protest? And how do parties and governments respond and shape this? We do not focus on normative moral questions, but combine both classic and contemporary theories and empirical research in both sociology and political science to arrive at an understanding. Also note, we focus on liberal democracies, most notably Western Europe, including the UK, but also the United States, Canada, Australia, and New Zealand. We use studies on those countries specifically, but also studies on cross-country comparisons. Now, let's look at a small selection of themes discussed in our master. Here, you see Pegida above and those who oppose them below. Pegida is a movement that opposes immigration, especially from Muslim countries. It started in Germany, but similar movements exist in other countries. What are the reasons for their opposition? From which social groups do supporters come from? Is, for instance, level of education, income, or gender relevant here? And how can we understand this? So how can it be explained that some groups support it more than other groups do? Additional questions we address. What are the motives for participation in protest? Since there are many more citizens with similar attitudes, yet a very small part of them actually engages in protest. How do parties and governments respond? Or do they perhaps mobilize this? And if so, how do they do this? Another example. The 2016 and 2020 US presidential elections. First Clinton versus Trump, and recently Trump versus Biden. Basic question, who voted for these candidates and why? But more specifically, how to understand the victory of an anti-establishment candidate and defeat of an establishment candidate in 2016? How are these choices related to other political attitudes? For instance, anti-elitism, political distrust, or gender beliefs? Another question, what is the role of the media in all this? And what is the role of the electoral system? For please note that in 2016, more people voted for Clinton than for Trump, but Trump was elected president. Now, these are also issues addressed by our current students in their master thesis, just like the issues addressed on the previous slide. Now we turn to our curriculum and the annual schedule. There are 4 terms of 10 weeks each. Courses in the darker shade of orange are devoted to our specialization. In addition, there is one methods course and one elective, which can be selected from other master specializations. Our first basic course is the social basis of politics. It addresses social differences in political attitudes and support for political parties and social inequalities in political trust and political involvement, both in the formal political domain and in non-institutional politics. Our second course is political attitudes and behavior in context. It focuses on the various institutional, cultural, and economic conditions relevant for understanding why political attitudes and behaviors vary across regions and change over time. We, for instance, focus on the role of welfare regimes, national media, cultural and ethnic diversity, and economic globalization. Our third course is Parties and Governments in Global Times, which discusses the challenges that political parties and governments face due to globalization. Instead of focusing on citizens, like in the first two courses, we now thus focus on political actors. An important question here is how global economic forces could limit the range of possibilities for politicians, political parties, and governments. Note different accents in the courses, from most sociology-oriented in the beginning to most political science-oriented in the end. Our mode of education is intensive. Regularly, you have 4 contact moments each week. That's 2 lectures and 2 tutorials. Our lectures are always interactive, which can be assured because of the relatively small number of students. We aim at 2 to 3 dozens of students as to provide optimal learning conditions. The small-scale tutorials have a different setup each week. Offer optimal training for the topic at hand. Students analyze and apply insight in group assignments. These tutorials also train students in practical skills on a master's level. For example, presenting, providing feedback, summarizing complex information, debating, and performing empirical research. You will write your thesis individually, but a large part of the work can be done collectively to make it more efficient. To that end, we often work in small, themed groups of approximately 3 to 4 students. The next slide gives you some examples of thesis projects fitting our program. Please take a moment to read them, for instance, by using the pause function in this video. In case one or more topics make you enthusiastic, this program is probably the right choice for you. In case none of these research questions spark any enthusiasm, then it is likely that another master's program will be more fitting. Now proceeding to your career prospects after completing our program. Note, it is not a vocational, but an academic training. So, in-depth expertise of politics and society, which is relevant for a lot of organizations, both within and outside the government, will be taught. After graduation, your sharp analytical sociological eye and your thorough knowledge of social scientific research provides a solid basis for favorable career opportunities in various fields. The 3 main gains from this particular program are 1. In-depth, state-of-the-art insights in the interplay between politics and society. 2. Strong analytical skills able to process a lot of complex information. Thirdly, knowledge of research not only enable you to do research yourself, but also to process research findings. The slide depicts four of our alumni working at NGOs, think tanks, or performing research at a university. Our alumni also work as policy officers at supranational, national, regional, or local governments, as researchers at governmental institutions, consultancy firms, and research centers, and as consultants for governmental or semi-governmental institutions. For those aspiring an academic career, it is possible to enroll in an abbreviated version of a research master here at campus, in case you complete our program with flying colors. Currently, three students that completed the Politics and Society program last year are finalizing that research master. Thus far, almost all who complete that research master program find a PhD position, and swiftly so. To wrap up, we provide a sociological perspective on the interplay between politics and society, instead of predominantly analyzing the political institutional domain, as in many programs in political science. Our staff exists of top academics who started this program because of their enthusiasm for the topics discussed. They have strong track records, including prestigious research grants and awards. We pride ourselves in that student satisfaction is consistently around 8.5 on a 10-point scale. I hope I gave you a good idea of our master's program and how it relates to other master's programs that focus on similar issues. More information can be found on our website. In case that any questions remain, please feel free to contact us. The slide provides our contact information. In case you share our enthusiasm for our program, I look forward to meeting you in September.